Aging Matters on BCTV is supported by the Berks County Area Agency on Aging.
Hello, and welcome to Aging Matters. This is a program that's provided by and sponsored by the Berks County Area Agency on Aging. My name is Ann Barlet. I'm the Public Advocacy and Outreach Manager for the agency. Our show today is information-packed, and I think most appropriate for many people. My guest today is David Shallcross, and he is the Director of Senior Protection Unit in the Office of Public Engagement for the Pennsylvania Office of Attorney General. So Dave, thanks so much for being here. You provide such wonderful information and a way for all of us to stay safe in our communities. So thank you for sharing your time with us.
Thank you, Ann. It's a pleasure to be here once again on Aging Matters here in Berks County. On behalf of our Attorney General, Josh Shapiro, we appreciate the opportunity to share great information with your audience all through the county of Berks. You know, this is a type of thing that everyone needs to hear about, regardless of your age, but definitely our seniors are really targeted on today's topic.
Okay. Well, and that's leading right into my first question, because our topic today is going to be talking mostly about romance scams. And, you know, it's terrible to have to think, even with that and that topic, that we have to be concerned about being scammed. And so I guess first we should start with the basics as far as what is a romance scam. But my other question is, you know, as you said, David, that this is, you know, our Aging Matters is usually for folks, you know, 60 and up, but I guess age doesn't matter on a romance scam, does it? But it does affect seniors as well. So just tell us a little bit about that and exactly what is a romance scam.
Absolutely, Ann. First off, I'd just like to share with everyone the fact that I am with the Office of the Attorney General, but I'm not a lawyer, and nothing I say today is legal advice. These are tips and resources to help guide us through some of the common frauds and scams that we see targeting our seniors, including the romance scams, sometimes also known as sweetheart swindles. And this is the fact that people are looking for communications, especially right now with COVID. A lot of folks are isolated, locked down and quarantined and that type of thing. So we're always craving that constant contact with someone. We want to be able to reach out and have someone to embrace and talk with. And I think romance scammers take advantage of that, because what they do is they use different ways of communication, including the internet, right? Social media is a huge resource for this stuff, as well as telephone and letters. And what happens is they look for people that are out there trying to connect. And what they'll do is they'll take advantage of that scenario, knowing that maybe they're lonely, maybe they're a widow or a widower, maybe they've just not connected, or a lot of their friends have passed and they have less circle of friends than they did at one time. And everyone's feeling a little depressed. It's winter time. It's COVID. We have all these things stacked up against us. And the scam artists look for those people that are willing and hopeful to find communications. And then those communications often turn into a little more detailed conversations. They get a little more personal and, of course, sometimes intimate, and become a romantic involvement, even though you may not be connecting with that person face-to-face today. You can still have that romantic feeling and that format in the conversations and the communications. And then the person's going to start to take advantage by asking personal questions, asking for your identifying information, like your date of birth or your social security number. They might not come out and ask for it straight up, but they'll find ways to manipulate you into sharing some of your interpersonal thoughts and communications with them. And then they turn it into, boy, you are just the right person for me. We need to meet up and connect. And everything sounds great until they start ripping you off.
So, yeah. And it sounds like they can do it in multiple ways. They can do it online, mail, et cetera. And I think that when you start to think about just people who are, looking for love or just companionship, the ability to talk to somebody, to make that connection, particularly people who are living in areas where their family may not be around. So that is limited, as you said, to COVID. We're staying home more, we're not going out as much, we're more isolated, so we're vulnerable to that. But just the idea that somebody who's just looking for somebody to talk with, and you know, maybe something in the future, is somebody out there is falling, is preying on people, is unnerving. And I think, you know, in today, people, because of technology and electronics, were encouraged at one point by friends to tap into that as a resource to meet people. So you know, we have a basics, but so who is doing this? Who are the people that are preying on individuals, and who is vulnerable to that?
Well, and you know, I'd like to share my screen. We have some great slides to go along with today's conversation. So let me do that real quick. And that way everyone can follow along. And we'll get everybody in understanding exactly what we're talking about.
All righty.
When it comes to these slides. So, you know, the romance scams, you know, exactly what you said. Yes, they are an issue today in the 21st century, right? We're encouraged to meet online. We're encouraged to just grab a quick coffee with someone and communicate, fast hookups, dating, companionship, dinner and a movie. It doesn't have to be romantic, right? Someone to do something with is always a nice thing to find. But when they start to blossom quickly into more romantic inclinations, that's when we have to be on guard. And we have to be able to understand that not everyone is who they say they are online. And these predators, like you said, they're preying on adults. It doesn't matter your age. They're out there. They're using your desire to meet and communicate as an anchor to pin you down and get information. And, you know, the online scammers, there's 25,000 of them that we are aware of. I'm sure there's much more, but that's what we know of. And, you know, who is this? These are the keyboard Casanovas, right? Right. You know, not to make fun of it, but I think people need to understand just how easy this is.
Yeah.
You know, 1 million Americans are being accessed online. There's over $1 billion in financial losses, according to the Better Business Bureau report. Now, think about that. $1 billion in losses. That's unbelievable.
And isn't
for
that
romance scams
that you're aware of, right?
There's yes. Yeah.
That have occurred that the person isn't reporting or you're unaware of. So that's just the $1 billion in losses that your agency has been made aware of, right?
Absolutely, right? So we know about that, but what don't we know about? You know, and people are hesitant and reluctant to report these type of frauds because they feel embarrassed greatly, right?
Absolutely.
But the average loss per consumer is estimated at over 18,000. I mean, you know, I can't afford to lose $18,000. I'd be devastated. And I'm sure you would too, Ann. And a lot of our listeners that are viewing on the show today, I think if you put that into your personal account and think about losing $18,000, what would that do to your personal finances, to your emotions, your physical health, right?
Absolutely.
Your well-being?
Yep.
You know, this has great impact.
It does. And, you know, I just, even from the very first word that you said, as far as, you know, these keyboard Casanovas, one who finally gets the courage maybe to begin this online system and then tries to find a site that they think is good site, you never once even think that the people who are on that site are part of a scam. You know, I don't think that even initially people even think about that. You know, you might think, oh, we're not going to be compatible. I don't like to do this. Maybe I won't get on every day. Maybe I won't like them. They won't like me. You've never once thought there was a potential of a scam. And then you say, you know, the widespread and the accessibility to make it widespread is just amazing.
And, you know, we all look for the good in people, right? That's a good thing that we do that. But equally, we need to be aware of the bad, because if we're totally blinded to the fact that people are lying, and if you look at the screen, 80% online lied about their age, height, or weight on online dating sites. So they're little white lies, right? Oh, I'll make myself a year or two younger to be more appealing. I'll pretend I'm a little bit taller. Hey, we all want to be skinnier, right? Yes. We all want to be, to what we believe others are looking for. So people will tell white lies and kind of stretch the truth a little bit. And that, I'm not worried about that, right? Those things can come out in the wash and you figure it out. What I'm worried about is the people that are just totally fraudulent. They're not who they are whatsoever. And they're just out there to take advantage of our seniors and anyone really, but our seniors are very much targeted here when you're trying to reconnect after being, with someone maybe a long term and losing that spouse. It's difficult. It's very emotional. And like you said, Ann, we're not thinking about, what about the fraud? What about the scammer? We're thinking about, can I find someone? We're focused. What we need to make sure we take a step back and understand that, no, not everyone's a fraud, but there's a lot of it out there and we need to be cautious.
Yes, exactly. So how is this happening? How is this occurring to people?
Well, I think that the first thing that occurs is we get involved in being on these social media platforms. And I'm not picking on any of them. Here's the popular social media platforms that people frequent, and that would be Facebook, Snapchat, Instagram, Twitter. And all of these have been able to have been faked. What I mean by that is they put up a false looking site. And on the site, they can add any information they want. They can use others' photos and pretend to be those people. They can develop a whole story, a backstory. It's amazing the lengths that these people will go to then fool you on these dating sites and social media platforms. Now look at the dating site. It's a target-rich environment because people that are lonely looking for others are all gathering in one place. It's what we call shooting fish in a barrel. I think you've heard that term, right?
Yes.
It's such a small pool of people that are all there for the same purpose. The scammers know where to look. So right away, they're going to go to dating sites and social media platforms. And, what we can do if we are visiting these sites for our own use, make your profile a little more robust, right? Don't sound needy or lonely. Don't be desperate in your tone because that's going to put a big check mark on your head, a target on your head, rather, for the scammers to start looking closely at you as a potential victim.
Okay. So I shouldn't say, you don't want to say anything like just simply widow looking for love.
Yeah, I'd avoid that, right? Maybe we want to be a little more mysterious, right? Okay. We want to say, mature woman looking for companionship and genuine interest, something of that nature. Leave it a little more, mysterious than I'm a widower and I can't stand being alone any longer. Well, boy, we're looking to target you because you're the person that's going to be ripe for the picking. And we don't really need to expose ourselves to that level. It would be much smarter to less is more in this particular situation. And you see how many dating apps there are. This is only a small selection, Ann. On the screen here, I've given you a few. And again, I'm not saying any of these sites are bad. I'm not saying that they're doing it to trick the consumers. The sites are a tool. It's just the platform that's being used by the criminal. So there's a lot of good people on these sites. There's a lot of genuine people. And you can find romance, I'm sure. But we have to be extremely, extremely careful because there's predators. You can go on a beautiful nature walk in our national parks and enjoy the beauty of the park, the wildlife, the birds, the sounds, and just have a great experience. But if you come across a mountain lion lurking behind a tree, you can have a very bad experience in that same beautiful place. So I just want everyone to know that there is predators on the internet in these social status platforms and dating sites. So even though the site might not be dangerous itself and what it is, this what's in the environment is what we have to be watchful of. Who's out there?
Okay.
Some of these emojis that are used are sometimes to portray a sexual innuendo. Okay. So we want to be aware of this. It's just so we're not making mistakes. I mean, a little octopus, cuddles, that's sweet. That's nice and cute. But, we get into some of these other things and we have to watch out for X-rated content and sending inappropriate images of each other, that kind of thing, sexting. These are not going to go anyplace positive. So folks, just really beat down that temptation to participate when someone else is encouraging and egging you on, because maybe they're not going to try to rip you off for your money, but once they have your photos of you in a compromised position, that's called sextortion. They could then use the photo to say, we're going to leverage, I'm going to put this photo on all social media sites openly and let everyone know what you're all about if you don't send me $10,000. So there's a whole other problem.
Yeah.
Catfishing is a television show, actually. If you watch that, it's on one of the major cable networks. It talks about these fake accounts, how people will trick others on these dating sites and social media platforms. You know, so it's not that if, that, well, this won't happen to me. It very easily could happen to you. It could happen to many people, and it does happen to many, many people, as you saw in the numbers in the beginning. So like when we're out there, let's make sure we're conscious that a lot of people are fake accounts. They do not use their appropriate names, their images, even video has been stolen from other people. As you see in the photo, this young lady is a nursing student, and her image was misused. So they'll take real people and then use their photos under new identities to then trick others. And a lot of times we see people posed as military. A lot of the ladies will be receiving images of very handsome men in their uniform. And they're maybe in overseas in service in Iraq, Afghanistan, what have you. And there's always a story, right? You know, yeah. Hey, I'm lonely. I'm in service to our great nation. And I just look for someone to communicate and connect with on a higher level. I just need that taste of home. I need someone to relate to me. I have no family. Well, you know, you're going to feel for our troops and our soldiers, and you're going to know that, geez, it wouldn't hurt for me to send them a little message. Well, no, it wouldn't. And they appreciate those messages. But I got to tell you, my wife and I volunteer with a military organization, with the Air Force, and we're part of the key volunteer group for family support and readiness. They do like to have messaging and conversation, but they will never be asking you to send them money. They will never ask you to do something and send your personal information to them or to open a bank account on their behalf and those type of things. So let's watch out for that kind of contact.
Well, and Dave, and maybe you're going to get to this a little later, but with that in mind, I think one of the questions is, you know, with something like that, sometimes, you know, when I go back to the earlier slide and it said 18,000-ish per, you know, per like an average. So in a scam like that, it probably doesn't, you're not hit with, hey, give me 18,000 right away. It's, I'll send a card and then I might make something. And then you may have a need to contact me, but need a card with money on it. And then I might send that in a small amount, right? It kind of can be a period of time where the predators are engaging in all of this conversation and taking advantage of somebody.
Absolutely. And you're exactly correct. You know, this doesn't happen in one shot most of the time. They groom you for months and years before they even ask for anything, right? So they want to build that trust. They want to build a relationship. Even though it's an online virtual situation, it is a relationship. You start to get, emotionally connected, and you start to feel for this other person. You start to actually enjoy and look forward to the conversations. Well, that's all part of the scheme. You know, these people are expert criminals. They know how to groom you and build this up and create that contact relationship. And those scripts that they write, they have an answer to everything before they engage you. And it takes months and months. And then when they do start asking, Ann, it's a little bit at a time, and then it grows, right? Like you said, I want to be able to contact you more. And we have to pay for our internet connection when we're not on official assignment, right? If it's a military person, maybe it's not someone who's posing as a military. Maybe they're just abroad because of business. They're in another country, or they're in a situation where their lifestyle has changed, and where they're at, they're moving and they're in the midst of relocating. So they don't have a permanent place for you to contact them. These are all schemes where it costs money, right? Mm-hmm. Send me that prepaid debit card so I can continue to pay for my internet connection so we can continue to have this conversation and this relationship built. You know, so these are all things that we have to watch for. The signs are out there. You know, when, if it starts on a dating site, and once you start to really connect with this person, usually within a few weeks to a few months, they might ask you to move on to a different site.
Oh, okay.
That's because some of these dating sites monitor for this as best they can. Now, they don't always detect it, but they are watchful when they can, especially the legitimate sites that are, you know, a little more responsible in what they're doing. But, you know, we have to be careful when we're asked to transfer to another platform or connection, and sometimes it's a private connection like a Kick Messenger, which is free texting and those type of things and videos and photos. A lot of times they might claim to be U.S. citizens, but maybe they're out of the country, like we talked about. And some can't wait. Some of these people that are new at this are going to ask for money much earlier than the real pros. So there's no gauge of, well, it's fake because they asked for money in the first 2 weeks, the first 2 months, the first 2 years. There's no gauge like that. You just have to be on guard throughout any of these online relationships.
I think I see the word travel in here too. These are kind of our red flags and our alerts or our tips. But, you know, also, as you were mentioning, you know, somebody could say, well, this occurred to me, so I'm a little shy of money right now. I had to lay out some money for something. You know, could you loan me money? Or in order for me to come and visit you, you know, sometimes they're not in your immediate area. So, or they say they're not in the immediate area. So they're asking for some travel, and it doesn't have to be a major travel, but expenses for that. So those are all ways that all this money builds up, and the ways that they kind of begin to pull you in, right?
Yes, definitely. And, you know, another big red flag is that we need to get together. I'm planning this big date for us. We're going to go for a beautiful dinner. We're going to go see a show, perhaps. We're going to do this, do that, right? I just can't wait to be near you and see you. And, oh, that sounds great, right? And right before they're to leave to come out and visit you, there's an emergency. Something has come up to change the plans abruptly, and there's nothing they can do about it, except they need money also. Not only can I not travel at this time, but I'm in a jam. So that's when a lot of the bigger ask for money, a larger amounts will be asked for when that occurs. Because now you're anxious because you planned this date for like 3 weeks. Mm-hmm. And all of a sudden they pull the rug out from under you and tell you, I wouldn't be able to come out at all maybe for quite some time unless I can take care of this problem. I need $8,000. I need $10,000, that kind of thing.
Yep. So then it begins. And so how do we, I'm glad you leapt right into it, how do we be more savvy? How do we become more safe? You know, knowing that we still want to meet up with somebody, and, you know, one of the ways to still do it is online. How are we going to be more safe?
Well, you know, limit what you put out there for public viewing. You know, when we have our security settings and our privacy settings, we need to make sure we're making sense of who is seeing what we're posting. Sometimes we open it up because we want to, you know, cast that net and attract other people. I recommend that you keep it limited. You try to connect with people that are friends of others that you know, rather than just an open stranger that you're trying to put out the information to. So privacy is important. Auditing and monitoring, make sure it is someone in your friends list. And if someone says, well, I'm a friend of yours, you know, Ann sent me, right? You know, if I get a message that Ann Barlet from Burke's Aging sent a friend request and they know someone who wants to connect with me, I'm going to call you, Ann, and I'm going to say, hey, Ann, did you tell Mary Sue to give me a ring or connect with me on social media? And you're going to go, I don't know her. And then I know I'm being scammed, right? It could be someone has hacked my account or perhaps your account, Ann, and they found your contact list or other information. Try to limit communications with strangers. I say no communications is my choice, right? But sometimes we open ourselves up a little bit. And you know, you got to be careful. You know, use the settings to be the guide. You know, go into your settings and see what it is and ask. You can always Google and Bing, whatever search engine you have. Type in, how do I set better privacy on, and then put in the name of the platform, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, whatever it might be, and go out there on Google or, like I said, Bing or any of those search engines and do a reverse image search. Like when someone sends you their photo online in these dating sites, make sure it's really their picture. You can do that easily for free right over the internet, right from your own desktop.
Cool. Okay. And so we have all of these people with fake accounts that we want to investigate, so we can do that reverse search. What else as far as anything else, or how do we, you know, or we can, as you said, check with friends and family. Hey, I saw this. What does this look like? See if they're aware of them. And what if I'm beginning to think, geez, this person has asked me for some money, and maybe I paid something and I let it go. And then again, it occurs, and maybe those red flags and those tips are coming to mind. What can I do at that point? Yes, I can, you know, immediately stop the communication if I can, but how do I report this? How do I alert, you know, that this person's doing this? Where should I go? How do I do that?
Well, that's very important to know, because we have to report this stuff, you know, and as you've seen in some of the photos that have been going across your screen, they take these images and you see the image of the actual scammer, in the background or next to it. Well, you're not going to see that when you're on the sites. You're only going to see the handsome gentleman or the lovely young lady in the, risque outfit at the nightclub, right? Those are the images you're going to get. So instead of just trusting the images, try to do a criminal background check. There's online sites that will do background checks of who people are. And some have a small fee, some have no fee, depending on how much information you're going to access. But you should always do some type of check on the person. Never provide information of yours to anyone else asking, right? Your bank, your credit card information, social security, date of birth, where you actually live. Don't share that either, right? And when I ask you to help them with their account, that's a scam.
Yeah.
Because somehow it has to go through your account to help them in their account. And that's when you get ripped off. They're going to clean you out. So we never send cash to anyone either. You know, people are always, well, they didn't ask me for a credit card number. Then we find out later in the conversation or the investigation, if we get lucky enough to actually open an investigation, they were putting money. One of the tricks scammers will use is take a magazine, your Good Housekeeping, your People, whatever magazine you like to read, Gardner's Weekly, and they ask you to stuff cash down in between the pages and then mail that, or these reloadable debit cards, you know, gift cards. Don't do it. And always just make sure that you're, you know, not giving out information to anyone. Check with friends and family. Let them know what's happening. Limit the photos that you send, because you're going to be receiving other photos from this person. They're going to be repeated, probably the same images. And usually they're alluring. You know, there's something to get your interest. That's usually a hype and a trick. If it looks too good to be true, it probably is.
And Dave, we need to wrap up, but I'm going to ask, how can we report this scammer, this person, the site, whatever, if we can wrap up our show with that real quick?
Well, you know, anything that's online, you can always make sure you make your report out to the FBI at ic3.gov. And, you know, I'm going to show you that slide so you have that information. There's also a scam where they'll pretend to be the authorities. So you have to watch out for the recovery scam. Hi, I'm the FBI. We are investigating this type of person online who's misleading others on these romance sites. We believe you might have been a victim. That's a scam too. They're not going to use your money to chase anybody. But on your screen right now is the ic3.gov. You can forward your complaints right there to the FBI's Internet Crime Complaint Center. And that's a great place to make your report. You can also let us know at the Pennsylvania Office of the Attorney General. You can send it to scams@attorneygeneral.gov as an email address. That's scams@attorneygeneral.gov. And you can always call our Senior Protection Unit at 1-866-623-2137.
Great. Well, thanks so much. That's really all the time we have for this show today. I thanks so much for Dave being present and giving us the information. Sorry, I think we're done, and tune in. See ya.
Thank you, Ann.
I think we were cut.
Aging Matters on BCTV is supported by the Berks County Area Agency on Aging.